Okay, here we are at round one, and we'll go on the draw. And this sounds pretty sexy. Yeah, all low drops. What could go wrong? No, really, it's fine. alright. Let's lead with, let's lead with the Flay Husk. I mean, we ran out of all this damage. Then, next turn, doesn't really matter, we'd run out this gold mirror, I guess. Just in case there's a 4-drop in there. So we should be right for mana. I mean, yeah, getting the extra swamp might be a challenge, but we should have more than enough time to get there by the time we get to 6 mana. So, yeah, let's run out this gold mirror. So many options. They're not terribly significant, seeing as how the options rely on what I'm going to draw. So, Rotwolf. Corrupted Conscience is nice. So, Rotwolf. Do I want to just trade with it with an Oriarch replica? Perhaps. Or might just want to take some damage, so let's just run out, let's go to the island, we'll play Oriarch Replica, and an Origin Spell Bomb, Impostor Turn. We're fine taking 2 poison damage, then can tag back for 4, I guess. We'll see. Tangle Angler, yeah, that's a nice one. Wouldn't mind Corrupted Consciencing him. Chooses not to attack. Interesting. If I don't Corrupt a Conscience the Tangle Angler now, I think Tangle Angler is powerful enough that it can justify using a card for it. And that's all from me. Not as exciting on this side of the table. Can't lure things into blocking it. But still. One of the best infect creatures. And I'm not too worried about him. Running out some crazy 5-drop bomb. Alright, Revoker naming Flay Husk. That's the play, right? Thinking. If you've never played with Phyrexian Revoker, you can find your card much faster by typing it out. Okay, Tangle Angler. Well, that was a mistake, because I don't have green mana, but anyways. If you type out the card you want rather than scrolling through a list. What now? Nope, okay. Do you want to attack me with Rotwolf? Signal Pest. Fantastic. Not particularly concerned. Alright, Big Long think about attacking with Rotwolf. Yeah, alright, so he's going to attack with Rotwolf and... Okay, and the Plague Mare? Sure. I'll bite. I'm fine trading with the Rotwolf here. He seems to be digging for land, but if he is, I don't know why he's sitting in a Plague Mare as well. Maybe he's just not thinking, because, this play just... really doesn't take advantage of Signal Pest at all. The same exact play would be much stronger. Well, still about the same next turn. So so I don't know. So leaving me the flail husk still activatable is quite nice. We're gonna cycle this away. Let's see what we draw. Sun Chaser, okay. That works. Let's. So we want to attack Flayer Husk to something. Not to Golmir, because I need it to play the Sun Chaser. Well, I guess I'll just attach it to the Sun Chaser. Make it a 4/4 flying. Sweet. And that is all. Attack with Tanglangler. I have to get in for 5 poison before it but I'm not really risking anything. So I may as well get in. Extremely unlikely that I win with poison damage, but it could happen. Well, the extra poison damage being relevant, I mean, it could play Phyrexian Juggernaut and win with poison damage, but the relevance is the issue. But when you've got nothing to lose, may as well. Man, if I draw that swamp to play the Carnifex Demon, it's gonna be nuts. Okay, so now we're getting in with the Sun Chaser. And play the Perilous Mirror. And equip. Just makes the trades the Perilous Mirror can do so much better. I mean, if it takes out Sunspear and Phyrexian Revoker. Yeah, that's fine too. My thing is, my blocks are just fantastic. There's no really good attacks for my opponent to do with what I've got on the table. Not this turn, not next turn. No. Phyrexian Juggernaut makes it even more deadly. So, I could attack with Perilous Mirror here. I mean, if he blocks with something, then I'm going to be killing at least one creature. That seems pretty tasty. Let's go with that. Let's get in with these two. Don't really need Perilous Mirror on the block, seeing as how I'm going to have a 5/5 and a 1/5 already. So I'm just guessing that's going to be in for 5. That would be best for my... Yep, in for 5. Alrighty. Let's bring out this Phyrexian Juggernaut. Sweet! Now, I mean, bit of a nombo when I'm doing pretty well on damage to be running out the big infect guy, but hey, he blocks and he puts pressure on too, whatever. So, something's gonna have to get blocked, and it looks like Phyrexian Juggernaut will have to be blocked pretty soon. Do I want to make Juggernaut a 6/6? So with 5, he could get double blocked by Sunspear and Partisan. I guess that's... I mean, if that happens, I kill Partisan, make Sunspear, Shikari a 1/1, and then do I really care? Do the math. Because if the Flayhouse stays on Perilous Mirror, Perilous Mirror is getting through, which will make it 5, putting into 5, but I don't think that really matters, because... once my opponent's down to... Oh, that's 2 damage extra. Once my opponent's down to 7... I'm still attacking for 5... Yeah, alright. I'm gonna leave it where it stands. Now... It's conspicuously got mana up, but I'm not worried. Okay. Shikari jumps in front. that works out just fine for me. Alright, alright. I'm still taking out three creatures. It's interesting to be blocking both damage and poison. I don't think that's the optimal play. Alright, so there's some kind of removal. Take mine, okay. Doesn't save your creature, but it does take out mine. Fine with that. I mean, I lose my poison guy, but I'm still dealing plenty of damage. So I think let's just next turn. Well, actually, next turn five. Yeah. So I'm going to deal it straight to my opponent, and then I have lethal on the board. Even before equipping. But I will also equip. Alrighty, good luck with that. Especially since Signal Pest. I mean, jeez. Certainly not stopping my flies. Alright, that's game one. Sideboarding. So let's have a look back. Against the green white not infect deck. So lots of two drops, so certainly Necropede and Oriok Replicas are getting value. There's not really anything that I want to bring in particularly. Priests of Norn is not better than what I've already got. I actually don't think, because I don't want to bring in Sirtak. I don't want to bring in Scrapdiver. I don't want to bring in Disperse, and Priest of Norn is just worse than the Necropede. So actually I'm going to leave it as is.